Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Blast Processing Podcast. I'm your host, Marcel Dorant, the content creator. And we have over here Mr. Terry Overholt, Suicyanide. How are you?
Finished your food?
Sorry, I had
We're all eating pizza here, everybody, so...
I had a mouthful of pizza. Sorry, guys. Hey, how's it going, guys?
And we got Mr. Matt Kingsley here, Raggedy Matt. How are you, buddy?
I'm doing pretty damn good.
Good, man. I'm glad to hear it. It's been a little while since we busted out a podcast
It's been quite a while, actually.
All been really busy, you know, doing other nerdy stuff.
Yeah.
And other channels, other stuff, which you should check out, of course.
Mm-hmm. Always.
We figured we would get off on a good roll here and start with a topic that I've actually had for quite a while here, everybody.
You're starting the podcast off today.
I'm going to start the podcast off
today. All right, I like that. Taking initiative.
All right, boys. What I got for you today, and for everybody listening, of course, we've all heard rumors and all those, you know, fan-started rumors about Netflix originals for Nintendo channels, Nintendo shows. And, they've had like April Fool's stuff where...
Yeah, like the Legend of Zelda one.
Legend of Zelda.
That was done by IGN, though.
And but it looks so good that you're like, this is official. No, it's a joke. I got Rickrolled again, you know?
I hate being Rickrolled. But I love the song.
I had something that I've been contemplating and I've been wanting to talk about on the podcast for a while and it just never came up, but I think this is the perfect time to do it. What I'm going to ask you guys is... What do you feel about Netflix specials for Nintendo or gaming shows? And do you believe that it should be played by A-list actors or should it be unknowns? And should it be real life or cartoon?
Okay, so it depends on the franchise, really. So if we're going back to Zelda, a live action one's probably going to be your best bet. But say Metroid might not work quite as well. So that could be like a 3D animated film. As for would it work, the answer is 100% no. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen any movie based on a video game that was any sort of decent?
There may be one or two, but they don't even come to mind. So,
like, most of them are a complete and utter travesty to watch. Yeah. Like, absolutely. I'm looking at you, Doom, and, like, DOA. Fucking terrible movies. Great franchises, though.
DOA movie was awful.
The second movie?
Are we talking about... live action films or
yes
okay because Warcraft looks really good but it's animated.
Actually, it's surprisingly a really good live action movie.
That's good.
It's like 50, it's like 20% live action, the rest is like CG'd as fuck. It's Avatar all over again.
But it's good though.
Yeah, it's really good. It's nice. Really fantastic. I've never been a big fan of live action video game adaptations because for some reason they never go with the right, like, the right characters or the right plot, or it never feels cohesive. Like, look at the Mario Brothers movie. Like, how much of a train wreck that was.
Anybody listening to this podcast probably knows that movie and how awful it was.
Yeah. What about the Payday web series? That's something I feel is really well done.
It's good. I have my issues with it. Like, some of the acting in it is absolutely god-awful.
A different voice actor for Bane, I didn't like that.
Yeah, a different voice actor for Bane. Giving Bane any sort of look at all was kind of dumb. Should never have happened. But yeah, I can't say, like, a web series is perfectly fine. We've seen, like, Castlevania did it really good. Like, there's a whole bunch of, like, small things like that.
Mortal Kombat did a great web series. Very good.
Street Fighter also did an amazing web series. But look at Street Fighter the movie and Street Fighter. Ooh, shit. The Chun-Li movie that they did. Like, both movies are god awful movies.
You know what else was god awful?
Except for Raul Julia.
Raul Julia, he'll always live in our hearts. May he rest in peace. And he was the best thing about that movie. The only good thing about that movie, really. Yeah.
Okay. I actually forgot what I was going to say. My apologies.
That's okay, buddy.
Give yourself some time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is we're loosening the ties here. You know, I'm buttoning the collars. It's all good.
Yeah.
No problem here. We got a little relaxed.
We're not popping the collars, though, right?
Yeah, no popping collars in this place. This is a collar-free popping zone.
Mm-hmm. No collars will be popped in this episode. And no toothpicks flipped either. Ain't no Razor Ramones over here.
Hey, Chico.
The best thing I still ever heard in any line of wrestling was his Hall of Fame speech. Bad times go come, bad times go, but bad guys last forever.
Like, it's such a Razor Ramon thing to
that
say.
You love it. You're like, let the man say whatever he wants, you know?
So yeah, what were you... talking about?
I still can't remember what I was going to say.
Okay, so...
How do you feel about... we got Kingsley's input there about Netflix series. What do you think? Does a Netflix series for a video game, like Nintendo, like a Zelda, or like Bayonetta, or even like Metroid, would that work on Netflix? Or do you think it's not going to work? It should be animated.
To be fair, if any place was ever going to do it and succeed, it would be Netflix.
I agree. Mm-hmm. I agree. 100%.
Oh, I remember what I was going to say. At least we can agree. Dragon Ball Evolution was horrible.
That movie does not exist. It is not a thing.
I don't know what you're talking about, but...
They did a live-action Dragon Ball movie? I've never heard of this.
Jesus, we should go back and look into that. Maybe it's good.
No, don't.
No.
Consider this a warning. Don't.
Like, I've seen web series with, like, 4 times less the budget, and that movie didn't have a budget at all anyway. That was, like, 1 billion times better.
Would you like to see JoJo's live-action?
No.
No?
We've actually had this discussion, me and my buddy Aldo. Mm-hmm. We're big fans of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, but that is one thing that you cannot translate well into, like, live action because of the art style and the overwhelming amount of poses. Mm. Like, it'd be watching a Vogue catalog most of the way through. Mm.
It's like reading the articles in the Playboy magazine. I didn't even know they had articles, so that was just the pictures. Jesus.
But yeah, no, JoJo's cannot translate well, plus... Going back to your topic about, like, should it be played with big-name actors? Mm-hmm. If they did a JoJo's live-action movie, they would have no choice but to go with people who aren't famous. Because no one is that stacked and can act that horribly. Like, Shatner could, but he's too old. Mm-hmm. Maybe get Shatner to be, like, old man Joestar. Mm-hmm. But, like, yeah. And as for Netflix series, like, not big name actors, but you can have big name actors in it. Look at the Netflix series for like Jessica Jones. Look at David Tennant and
Kristen Ritter. She's
Renner, yeah. Like, you can have decent actors, but try to give new people a chance. Mm. We can't be watching the same actors
Charlie
forever.
Charlie Cox, the guy who plays in Daredevil, who plays Matt Murdock in Daredevil.
Oh, yeah, he's fantastic.
He's amazing. I don't think I've ever
seen
anything
else. Ben Affleck, who?
I will say, Ben Affleck, I gotta admit, you know, staying on topic with all this, like, superhero stuff here, he's done better than anybody expected he would do. You gotta give him that.
Oh, yeah,
like,
for Batman v Superman. And
that movie was not his fault at all.
Yeah, no. He's the only redeeming thing about that movie.
He was fantastic. I liked him better as Bruce Wayne than Batman, to be honest.
Well, yeah, he was fantastic as both, actually, to me.
I was very impressed. I knew from the beginning. I know a lot of people may raise their eyebrows here, but I honestly knew from the beginning that he would... do amazing, because every movie you've seen him in, he was good.
Well, no, he was really actually bad in Daredevil when he played Daredevil the first time.
Yeah, and he knew that, and he actually felt really bad about that, because he wanted that to be good. He wanted Daredevil to be amazing.
You know what?
What's up, buddy?
This is a really good topic. I like this topic, because it's a perfect segue into one of my topics.
Oh, beautiful.
So if you want, you can just take over then.
Well, friggin' bring that bad boy over, rev it up, and segue it on over here.
Suicide Squad.
Oh, cool.
Suicide Squad. No spoilers.
So, no spoilers, please, because I haven't seen this movie.
Great movie, though.
Great. Oh, fantastic movie. Do not listen to the reviews. Give this movie a chance. Spoiler, Joker's in it. Oh, my God. No, Suicide Squad was amazing. Me, you, and Tracy went last night.
Yep.
At the Penn Center Theater there in St. Catharines. It was fantastic.
Oh, yeah.
It was a good program.
Yeah. I'm going on... Tuesday the 10th. So, I'll be watching that by myself, more than likely.
That's
in
okay.
In a theater all by myself, jacking off to Harley Quinn.
Yeah, going to a theater by yourself is not fucking weird at all, right?
But yeah,
it's okay. Me and Marcel, I think, popped huge ones when we first saw Harley.
I have one bone to pick with Suicide Squad.
Ha! Well, so do I,
and
buddy.
That is...
Sorry.
Good one.
It's a 9-inch bone.
Barrel.
So my biggest gripe is actually with Margot Robbie in that film. Harley Quinn is from Brooklyn.
Yep.
She's got a thick Brooklyn accent.
Hey, Mr. J.
Like, she has a huge Brooklyn accent. Yet Margot Robbie doesn't even attempt it. Like, not even a southern accent to, like...
No, she does. You hear it throughout the film.
Yes and no. Yes and no.
It's nowhere close. at least Leto gave himself like a very Joker-esque vibe to his like the way he talks. So I'm okay with that. But like Margot Robbie, no. I want to see a supercut of that movie where they actually give her the right voice. Just somebody dub over all of her parts.
Yeah. Maybe the original voice actress.
Yeah.
Oh man, the best. Oh.
Tara Strong?
That.
Oh yeah.
God bless her. She's awesome. She's an amazing voice actress.
Yeah.
Mm. She has the voice of Gohan. No, Goten. Little yeah. Goten from Dragon Ball Z.
Fucking love Dragon Ball Z. Mm. Speaking of Dragon Ball Z.
She also voices Twilight Sparkle.
Speaking of Dragon Ball Z.
Okay.
Hey, man. I'm happy with my my choices.
What were you saying about Dragon Ball Z there, Kingsley?
So, we're going to show Marcel here some Dragon Ball Super.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to get to meet Black Goku. It's a horrible name for the character. Should have been Dark Goku, but, you know.
Maybe that's what it means in the translation.
I hope to God, because they really fucked up Super Saiyans. Saiyan God Super Saiyan.
Yeah, just call Super Saiyan Blue. Super Saiyan Blue. We're all
not
happy
even
with that.
No. It should have been Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan God 2.
Fair enough.
Or just like Saiyan God and then Super Saiyan God and then Super Saiyan God 2, because you know that fucking thing is coming sooner or later. It's like Goku with pink hair. Like rainbow colored trout hair. But yeah.
Do you think they're taking it too far with this whole Super Saiyan God thing?
Yes. I think like right now, stop focusing in on like the whole evolution of or transformations thing that they've been on a kick for Dragon Ball.
Mm-hmm.
And like focus in on something new for them. Like go back to fusions.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Amen.
But yeah, I'm really liking Dragon Ball Super. It's a really, really good show. Drags on in the first half of it because, you know, just the last two movies recapped over like 12 episodes. But yeah, it's a pretty decent show. So anything else over there, Terry? You had another topic you were going to bring up.
Another topic. Yeah, I have a topic.
So bring it on.
Alright, so this is going to be a little bit of a veer off from the usual gaming kind of topics. We're going to go with something a little bit different. We're going to go into the sports entertainment world.
Okay.
Alright, I think you guys know where I'm going with this.
Mm-hmm. It fits right in with this, because we were just talking about Razor Ramon.
Exactly.
Perfect segue. Hey-o.
There we go. What do you guys think of WWE doing the brand split again?
This whole new era of WWE. It can't be anything but good.
Yeah.
The problem with having all of the roster in one segregated place is that they can't push certain characters as much.
Yes.
So at least having it on two different shows, you get to push more people into like the top spots.
Yeah.
Like, for a while there, Dolph Ziggler was doing jack shit all.
Yeah.
Dolph Ziggler is fantastic.
Oh, he's amazing. He's like the next Mr. Perfect.
Yeah, it's perfect. But, yeah, for a while he was just doing nothing, just the side character for like jokes. But yeah, I really am happy that they're doing the brand split again.
I really like this new era
that, you know, getting rid of fucking Roman Reigns, putting him back to the mid card where he belongs. Stay there, motherfucker.
And bringing new guys, giving new people a chance.
Finn Balor.
In the case of Finn Balor.
I always knew he was going to be amazing.
He is very amazing.
He impressed me big time after I saw him.
He's great. He's a great wrestler, a great star. He does have to fix his entrance. It's kind of weird.
I love his entrance.
It's really weird. That does not need to be fixed at all.
Man.
Yeah, that totally needs to be fixed. Just like Sheamus's horrible, horrible whiteness needs to be fixed.
Oh yeah, where he stands there.
If you slap your own chest and your chest becomes a whole different person in color,
yeah,
like
you need to go tan.
Go to a tanning bed.
It just makes me laugh. I like Sheamus though. He's a great, great wrestler.
Yeah. Sheamus, great wrestler. Get rid of the mohawk from death. Like, what the hell is that thing made out of? I've seen him being given like pile drivers and it hasn't even moved.
That's true, man.
That's great.
Yeah. With certain superstars like Seth Rollins being back in it,
That's cool.
After his injury, like, I really like Rollins. He's a great worker. He's a great...
Seth Rollins is fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing worker.
The rumor that Kurt Angle is coming back.
I heard about that.
That'll be pretty good. Same with CM Punk. Apparently, after he finishes his first fight in the UFC, he's supposed to be coming back.
Really?
Yeah.
That I honestly thought that CM Punk would never come back.
Oh, I'll guarantee you. It's all money.
Yeah.
Money is money.
And Vince will take him back because he knows he'll bring in money.
Oh, yeah. That's all talent. It's raw talent. Even if he's an asshole, talent is talent.
Oh, yeah.
You need that money. You need those dollars.
Yeah. Dollar, dollar. Put them on ice cream sandwiches like you wanted. The ice cream bars?
Yes,
put,
yeah, yeah.
Ice cream bars and, you know, they'll fly off the shelves. I'm telling you. Oh, yeah.
But, happy about what they've been doing. I love the fact that they brought back Stephanie and Shane.
Yeah, Shane O'Mac.
I love Shane O'Mac.
McFoley being back as GM.
Daniel Bryan getting back in the company doing something.
Yeah. Daniel Bryan, like, our fucking hero.
Yeah.
Was the one who should never have been pushed, but got pushed.
Yeah. Because we all believed in him.
Exactly. It was the fans who made him rise. And exactly. That's special.
Exactly.
That's not Hulk Hogan right there.
Yeah.
Hogan, except the worst pile of crap for wrestling.
We all know Daniel Bryan is a way better worker than Hogan.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like, four moves. It's like a leg drop, a fucking elbow drop.
A big boot.
A big boot.
And punches.
Yeah, punches. And the Hulk up thing. Yeah. Punch, like, he can point.
Him and Shawn Michaels had the match, and Shawn Michaels
oversold
it hard.
I love so this. Good. I love Michaels' cell job.
If you don't know about that, look that up. Shawn Michaels' Hulk Hogan cell job. Look it up on YouTube.
Oh, it's the funniest the shit ever. It's so good.
Do you remember? Okay, this was a while ago. All three of us were there, ironically. It was at Marcel's place when he was living in St. Catharines the first time. And he organized us all in his house, in his room, to watch WrestleMania.
Oh yeah, I remember
it
that.
Was me, you, Gizmo, Kingsley, and we also had your brother and Andrew LeBlanc all there. We marked out huge during the Michaels Undertaker match.
Oh yeah, it was fucking fantastic.
Best match ever. Unless you count Randy Savage and Ricky Steamboat in WrestleMania 3.
Yeah.
Forever will be my favorite moment, because it's fucking...
The Macho Man.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage. Like, ooh, yeah!
Yeah, I can't believe you know how to do that.
I love Macho Man. Like,
all right, there, Spider-Man! Fallout. I got you for 3 minutes!
Fallout.
Oh, yeah, the fact that, like, you can mod Fallout to have freaking Macho Man, Randy Savage Deathclaws. Like, I won't play the game any other way now.
That's awesome.
Same with Skyrim. I can't play Skyrim without Macho Dragons.
What?
Oh yeah, they did the same thing for dragons in Skyrim.
You
it
have
was fantastic.
To show me. You have to show me. I'd love to see
it's
that.
It's almost as awesome as the Thomas the Tank Engine mod.
Oh my god!
It turned all of the dragons into Thomas the Tank Engine, right down to his toot toot. Like, if you watch the intro for Skyrim with that, you will be in tears laughing.
That's hilarious.
It's so good.
That's hilarious, man.
But yeah. Really looking forward to seeing more for this WWE stuff, especially with this pay-per-view coming up with Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's fantastic. Fantastic thing. Finn Balor versus Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins, yeah.
It's going to be great.
Sasha Banks versus Charlotte.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
Me too.
The boss. She's going to take it.
She's got to. Like. Yeah. We don't need Ric Flair again. We don't need his daughter doing 16 time world champion.
You know, being the champion.
Who do you think is going to win the Universal Championship? Rollins or Balor?
Balor.
Balor by far?
Balor's going
Rollins.
To win it.
Rollins.
That's going to win. I got to go with Balor on this.
I want Balor to win, but I'm telling you, Seth will win.
Yeah. Wait, no, yeah. Think about it. They'll push it so that there's a rivalry between Rollins and Balor. Mm-hmm. And if he wins here, Rollins wins here, they can go all the way to WrestleMania with this.
They could.
Like, that's story right there. Yeah. Running itself. What I'm hoping, though, is that for SmackDown, immediately following the match with, following the match for, Undertaker, or not Undertaker, fucking,
Orton
versus Brock. I want Kurt Angle right at that moment going in and challenging Brock Lesnar to a match. Mm-hmm. Two Olympic style wrestlers going against each other.
That would be fantastic. I would love to see that.
That's plus, they had one of the best rivalries back in the day.
Amazing, because they were friends Brock in real life, so they worked so well together.
Yeah.
You know who they're. You know who's going to be coming back. When he's going to come back, he's going to come back against Rusev.
Yeah, that too. Rusev would be a perfect opponent for him, like the American Hero versus the
Bulgarian Brute.
Bulgarian Brute, like that would be an amazing match.
Rusev.
I don't like Rusev.
I do love Lana though. I always did.
Oh, Lana's fantastic, but Rusev, like, you need a new gimmick, buddy.
Yeah.
Oh, they're just trying to do another Umaga.
Yeah, it was Umaga. Fucking before that, they had
Umaga Light.
Yeah. It's like, gimmick. Characters like that, he needs a better personality than just some Russian guy who kicks the shit out of people. Yeah, like, we've all seen Rocky 2.
Yeah, we don't need another Ivan Drago. If he does, he does.
That's good.
It's we like, will win the crusty, we shall crusty Americans. Like, why do you always want to crush us? What do you ever fucking, the fuck,
what
man?
The fuck did we ever do to
and
you?
And then you go, oh, wait, okay, we did do lots of stuff to you, but still, come on. Yeah.
Like, well, we're bros, right?
For that. You can't be like us, like here in Canada, where. We're always like, hey there, buddy, wanna come get a hit over here? You know,
can't be nice like us Canadians.
Yeah,
go fuck yourself.
Yeah,
Canadians aren't actually nice.
Well, it's that's just the plan. We'll lay low for 200 years, and then out of nowhere, we'll just spring on you. Just take turkey.
You think you're safe, but you really aren't.
Call it ham.
Yeah, go for turkey and just take it. And we're naming it chicken, you morons. good old Jeremy Haas.
Yeah.
Good old Jeremy Hotz. Look him up on Just for Laughs. Oh, Jeremy Hotz.
Fantastic.
H-O-T-Z.
H-O-T-Z. So, yeah.
This will bring me into my topic.
Oh, lovely. So, what do you got for us, Mr. Kingsley?
So, speaking about superheroes and stuff, like I
what? You like superheroes?
I like Batman movies.
Another podcast. Another topic.
Speak about superheroes, and we were just talking about how you got Arkham Knight on PC.
Yes, sir, I did. I swallowed it, and I know it got bad reviews for a PC version, but I figured for $19.99, it was worth the gamble.
But apparently, over the last like year and a half, we've been getting really badly shafted on PC for superhero games.
We have. What is up with that?
Four in a row now.
What are the? Do you know the other ones?
So Arkham Knight. Got screwed by bad development time.
Yeah.
The two remakes for the Ultimate Alliance were both horribly broken at launch.
From what I heard, yeah.
And the new Batman by Telltale is also really broken on PC. Hmm. It's like unplayable. Mm-hmm. So that's four licenses and for like two comic book Batman heroes. Movies. And both of them, all of them just don't work.
Hmm. Yeah, like, I've seen a dip. Even Arkham Origins on my Wii U, because I know on the Wii U it didn't, the developers there, when it came to the Wii U, because you got to understand, ladies and gentlemen, the Wii U
is basically a weaker 360. Yeah,
like, I'll give you an example. For Ubisoft, you can look this up, it is documented, and I wouldn't say it if I wasn't 100% sure, but, and anybody here can go tell me, in terms of sales... I forget the exact numbers for Xbox One and PS4, but they're good. They're maybe like neck and neck with each other. And then you have like the PC, which is somewhat okay, but not bad. If you have a Wii U console, and if you're Ubisoft, Ubisoft only gets 1% of their sales comes from the Wii U. Only 1% out of 100% is the Wii U. And then like maybe 25 or 30% is like Xbox, and then like another 30% or so or is that PS4, then you got maybe 40% for like PC, right? But like, and the Wii U is only 1%. So on the Wii U, it seems like the developers just don't put as much effort, like even going as far as to exclude, whose phone was that?
Was mine. Mine's on silent.
Exclude features completely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So what I was going to say is, like, have you noticed over the past, like, 2 or 3 years that developing games for PC seems to be going down? Like, it looks like most developers now are focusing specifically on console targets and,
which,
like, porting things to PC, which it isn't so much odd. It's just, like, we have this uber technology, like, it's a PC. It's vastly superior. So why not develop for it and then scale back for consoles?
How many people actually have gaming PCs like this? Like, in terms of how many people have consoles? Well, I can look up
the numbers, but I'm pretty sure it's
neck and neck?
Like, about the same market share as what PlayStation 4s and Xbox Ones have.
Mm-hmm.
It's about in the same general. And Wii U is, like, way down there.
Wii U is almost non-existent.
And mobile is actually the highest.
Well, yeah, because mobile's so accessible, and you put a free app on there, and you get them to pay $2 for coins. It's perfect.
Yeah, look at Pokemon Go.
Pokemon Go, everybody.
Look at Pokemon Go, man.
Well, what's up, Pokemon Go, you know, Mr. Terry?
It's a mobile game. And it's all the rage right now.
Yeah.
That's right. It's $9 billion in the bank for Nintendo.
Oh, yeah.
It was $9 billion. And immediately after, they finally decided to say, hey, guys, we didn't develop this game. Niantic did. And their stocks immediately fell by $8 million, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
It was pretty abysmal.
Wow.
Immediately after, to just watch the stock market go...
Mm-hmm.
For Nintendo. But to be fair, they had to shoot themselves in the foot like that, because with the two new Pokemon games coming out, I think like having Pokemon Go would have overshadowed it quite a bit.
Agreed.
And it wouldn't have made any sales for the new Pokemon Go Pokemon games.
Mm-hmm.
So rolling back some of that like press for Pokemon Go was a smart decision.
Agreed. They had the handhelds, the 3DS, the 2DS, and the new 3DS needs to be their priority in terms of Pokemon.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I hope we're not straying too far from the topic here by going off on Pokemon.
But oh yeah, who cares?
Yeah, yeah, but like, we totally should.
Stop this train.
Wanna get off, go out home again, yeah. Follow John Mayer fans out there.
But yeah.
Peanut gallery over here, everybody.
But yeah,
You're funny.
Yeah, it really seems weird that, like, over the past generation, people have, like, just stopped making games specifically for PC and started focusing on console hardware, which just seems like a return kind of to form if you think about it, because, like, this happened back in the Atari age, the Nintendo age, the SNES era. It wasn't until, like, the PlayStation, like, I think the fourth generation of consoles, where PC started to dominate again.
Mm-hmm.
So, it seems like time's just splitting around again.
Mm-hmm.
We got Marcel over here trying to take a picture of us all.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Hang on.
Oh.
I'm a loser.
I can't even...
Yeah, we can't even see Terry here. I'm not a girl, so I'm not good.
So he's just trying to position the camera so that he sees all of us.
Yeah, there we go. Oh, hang on, let me just... There we go.
There we go.
Beautiful.
All right.
So,
ladies and gentlemen, you can go to our Facebook page and you can see that photo when it's uploaded.
We're going to post them up immediately and, you know, you'll be able to see that no problem.
Oh, yeah.
Now... And I don't know if there's any listeners out there that have heard us that are from the Hamilton area, but in case you missed us,
Hamilton?
We were at Con Bravo this past weekend.
Yeah, we did some myself cosplay and, events over at Con Bravo.
Yep, myself, Raggedy, Matt.
And our buddy Chad.
Yep.
We decided to do Payday Gang for another stint.
Yep.
Did it only another for the one day, but another casing job.
Yep.
Another con job, if you like. Yeah, it was pretty cool. We got some new photos. You can go check us out on Penguin Uprising Cosplay.
Yep.
So, it was pretty fun.
My first event.
Yeah, it was first event as Houston. First event for our cosplay group.
Yep.
Gonna get Marcel in on this sooner or later.
Yep, and Tracy.
I'll be
along with that. Don't you worry about that, everybody.
Oh, yeah. It's cool. We do these things and do it for charity as well.
Like, donate
money. Cosplay for the Cure.
Always about charity. Yep. It's always about for the right cause. And being nerdy and having fun at the same time. That's definitely the way to do it.
Yeah, just being ourselves.
Exactly. And that was great. The JoJo Posing Academy.
Oh, yeah. That was an amazing thing. Like, had an entire thing devoted to just posing like JoJo from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
I am just getting into that anime. Because Raggedy Matt just
got
me addicted to it.
Fantastic show.
And then,
if you have not seen JoJo's Bizarre Adventure,
do
yourself a favor.
It
is fantastic. But yeah. we're rolling up on 30 minutes here.
Oh, nice.
So
what you're saying is we have another 30 minutes. That's fantastic. No.
Well, we have another one after this, so...
yeah, there's plenty of content.
Oh, yeah. We'll figure out some stuff, and we'll come back to you. So this has been the Blast Processing Podcast. This is the Raggedy Matt.
Hello, Matthew.
Hey.
The content creator, Marcel Dorant.
And I'm Suicyanide from Darkstalker Gaming.
We shall talk to you later.
Talk to you later.
Goodbye.
Take care of each other.
Goodbye.